I'm Adam.
And I'm Woody.
And this is
Where there's a Williams, there's a way.
Hey Woody, have you ever wondered all about our world and the people that live in it?
Only when I'm hungry.
What?
Oh no, not because I eat people. It's just when you get so hungry, you have to start thinking about stuff to get your mind off all the hanger.
Okay. Today's book explores different aspects of our world and the people that live in it. Let's get started.
If You Come to Earth by Sophie Blackall. Dear visitor from outer space, if you come to Earth, here's what you need to know. You can find us near a big sun and a tiny moon, and a bunch of other planets. Ours is the greeny-blue one. The green and brown bits are land, and the blue stuff is water. People mostly live on the land, in big cities, and small towns, and tiny villages, or just in the middle of nowhere. We live in all kinds of homes.
We lost our homes, in a fire, in the flood, in a war,
in all kinds of families. There are more than 7 billion people on Earth. We all have bodies, but everybody is different.
Whoa, did you see everybody chasing that guy? I bet he has beef jerky in his pocket.
Beef jerky? I don't think they were chasing him, but they were in a race.
Isn't that technically still chasing him?
I guess so. I've never really thought about it like that.
I could totally catch him.
I should hope so. You're a tiger.
Yeah, you're right. Tigers are the best.
Except for my friends who are identical twins and look the same, except for Mustafa's mole. Inside our heads, we are usually thinking. You can't see our thoughts. But sometimes we show our feelings on our faces. Even if we don't feel like it, we get dressed every day. We wear different clothes depending on what we do, and where we live, and if it's hot or cold.
False. I never put clothes on. And it looks like you wear the same thing every day. Don't you ever get tired of that tie?
I wear other things, but this is just my outfit for doing these videos.
There's lots of different weather in the world. Some of it's good, and some of it's bad. Wherever people live, we usually have to go someplace else. There are lots of ways to get there. I'm a kid and kids go to school to learn stuff, so we'll know what to do when we're grown up. Grown-ups do lots of things to make the world work. But when people are not at work or at school or sick or asleep, we get to do whatever we want. Whatever we're doing, we need to eat when we are hungry. Some of us have more food than others. We all need food and water to survive.
Look at all those people sharing just one turkey. That wouldn't work for me.
Why not?
I'd eat the whole thing and then everybody would get mad at me. That's why we do all of our family get-togethers at an all-you-can-eat buffet.
We get water from the rain, which flows into little streams and big rivers and all the way to the sea. You can't drink the sea because it's too salty. The sea looks empty, but actually it's full. Fish can swim, but they can't walk. Most animals can walk or swim or gallop or hop, but they can't fly.
I can fly!
Did you see me?
Yes, I can see you.
No, in the book, I was front and center.
Oh yeah, you were in the fold.
Too much majesty for one page.
Some birds can swim and walk and fly, so if I had to choose, I'd be a bird.
I can't fly.
Birds can sing, so can whales, and people. People make all kinds of music, on our own and all together. Some of us who are deaf talk with our hands and faces. Some of us who are blind read with our fingers. If we are blind, we can imagine colors as shapes and sounds. These are the colors you need to paint everything in the world. Some things are part of nature. Some things are made by people. Some things are big. Some are small. Some things are invisible. Wind, invisible cloak, ghosts, gravity, electricity, the smell of roast chicken, old socks, frangipani, wet wool, sound waves, germs.
If I don't eat every 2 hours, I turn invisible. How does that work? My stomach starts growling and then I'm out of here.
That's not really turning invisible, just leaving.
Either way, you won't see me anymore.
Some germs can make you sick. So can eating a woolly milk cap toadstool, or breathing in smoke, or getting spat on by a slow loris. Sometimes people get hurt by accident. Sometimes we hurt each other. Mom! Mom! It's better when we help each other. Babies are not very good at anything. Kids are good at a lot of things. Grown-ups can do just about anything until they're really old. But by then, the babies are grown up and can help. Older people are good at telling stories about the world when they were young. Kids are good at making up stories that haven't happened yet. There are lots of things we don't know. We don't know where we were before we were born, or where we go when we die. But right this minute, we are here together on this beautiful planet. If you come to Earth, you can stay in my room. Love, Quinn. P.S. How many eyes do you have? Are you small or big? Do you have any pets? When is your birthday? Is it always dark where you are? Are you going to visit us? My friends and I want to know.
Wait a second. Is this book really a guidebook for aliens?
No, not really.
This Quinn person seems to think that Earth is going to be taken over by aliens.
I think you're misinterpreting the point.
Hello, visitors and new masters. The first thing that you should know is that tigers are awesome, but they taste terrible.
We've really gotten off track here.
The idea for this book arrived on top of a Himalayan mountain in Bhutan. I was working with Save the Children and had climbed a zigzagging path to reach a tiny two-room school with 10 students. We couldn't understand a word each other said, but the children drew pictures for me and shared their lunch, and I showed them some books. I have made books about boars and babies and bears and lighthouses, but what I wanted in that moment was a book that would bring us together, a book about their home and mine. I wished for the same book when I was with children in Rwanda and the Democratic Republic of the Congo, in India and Singapore, and in Brooklyn, New York. And so, I decided I would make such a book. But I was going to need a lot of help. I talked to children all over the world and spent time in Brooklyn New School, where I made 23 new friends who gave me lots of ideas about how to explain our world to someone from outer space. Those children, Ava, Alex, Ari, Athena, Bernadette, Callum, Carolina, Denbell, Iron, Finn, Corolia, Gus, Ida, Iris, Karen, Lucia, Markel, Mia, Moxie, Nile, Noon, Tehutaminera, and Willa are the students in this classroom image in this book, along with their teacher, Ms. Greta. I'm grateful to them for their thoughtful, hilarious ideas. I told them making a book takes a while. I didn't expect it to take 5 years. As the idea for the book took shape, I knew there needed to be one kid writing the letter. I'd met thousands of smart, endearing children. How could I possibly choose only one to be our narrator? Then I met Quinn. Quinn has lived in Nigeria and Indonesia and Nepal, but when we met, he and his family were living in Australia. Quinn's brother Elliot was busy with a lizard, so I asked Quinn all the questions, ending with, "What kind of snack would you give a visitor from another planet?" "Mashed potatoes," he said without hesitation, "because we don't know if they have teeth." And then he slid over 17 drawings he'd made on flashcards while we were talking of different planets and their possible inhabitants. I had my kid. There are nearly 8 billion people on Earth. I could only fit a small number into this book. Some of my friends and neighbors, some are families I saw picnicking in Central Park, some I met at a market in Yangon, on a bus in Beijing, on a boat in Sydney, in a cow stall on a dairy farm in Hobart, New York. Almost everyone in this book is based on a real person. Some of them, like a few in the pages about things grown-ups do, are people you might recognize. We humans define ourselves by where we are born, where we live, what we believe, by the clothes we wear and the languages we speak. But there's no typical person. We're all different. Yet there's something we all share, the planet on which we live. This world of ice-capped mountains and sandy deserts and grassy plains, of winding rivers and glacial lakes and glittering seas, of bustling cities and busy towns and sleepy villages. This world that contains all our food and all our water and all the art and books and music and every ant and every sneeze and every comma, every atom of every living and non-living thing. This planet that carries all that we hold dear orbits the sun in our solar system. The sun is a star, and it's one of billions of stars in our galaxy, which we call the Milky Way. The Milky Way is one of billions of galaxies in the known universe. Astronomers estimate there may be billions of other planets a bit like Earth where life forms could exist. There are lots of things I don't know. I don't know if there is life elsewhere in the universe, though I find it hard to believe we are all alone. But I do know this. Right this minute, we're all here together on this beautiful planet. It's the only one we have, so we should take care of it. And each other, don't you think? Sophie Blackall.
I hope this book helped you see our world and the people that live in it a little differently.
Yeah, kind of like when you're squinting or a house of mirrors.
I was thinking more like a giant house that all of us share.
One that's really nice but still has sections with a leaky roof and a kitchen with a personal chef. One that'll make you anything you want. Like,
Woody? Hello?
Huh? Oh, I was just thinking about lunch.
That seems on brand. Thanks for joining us today. I hope that you enjoyed the book. I'm Adam.
And I'm Woody.
And this is
Where There's a Williams, There's a Way.
Did you know the oldest person ever to live was Jean Louise Calment? She lived to be 122 years and 164 days. She was born February 21st, 1875 in Arles, France, and died August 4th, 1997, also in Arles, France.